So today I want to talk a little bit about alkaline water. In general, supporters of alkaline water claim that it's healthier than regular water and it can prevent or treat a wide variety of different diseases. It's loosely related to the practice of an alkaline diet, which involves eating quote-unquote alkaline food, so this video is basically going to be covering both because they pretty much make the same claims. I could just, you know, list out everything that alkaline water is supposed to do for us, but instead, I think it's more appropriate that we let an expert explain.
First of all, let me just talk about some of the benefits. The benefits is going to help detox your body. It's going to clear up your skin. It's going to help with the energy efficiency of your body. Your appetite will decrease because you're absorbing more nutrients now. Hair starts to grow a little bit more. Everything just goes to the next level. I can spend about an hour just talking about every single thing. But your whole body goes to the next level. Digestion, mood, focus, everything. Because the reason why we don't have the superpower that we should have is because we're so toxic.
After hearing that it could take me to the next level, I was definitely interested. However, I wasn't really clear on what this meant. So I quickly opened up Google and I did some searching to see how this could benefit me. After just a few minutes, I was able to compile a list of the most common ways that alkaline water and an alkaline diet is supposed to help. After compiling the list, I got pretty excited because, you know, it seems like it just cured everything. You know, regardless of what was wrong with me, it seems like this alkaline water is a pretty good fix. After seeing the list, you might be thinking the same thing, and your first question is probably, you know, how do you get your hands on it? Well, there's a few methods that you can do to get alkaline water, but I'm going to start with the most expensive one. To do this, I opened up Google and I made a quick search, just, you know, alkaline water machine, and I scrolled down and clicked on the Amazon link. What we have here is a machine that's going to generate alkaline water for us, and it's at a very reasonable price of $1,500. At first, it might seem like $1,500 is a lot of money, but you have to remember that it cures everything, so in the end, it's a pretty good bargain. When we look at the item description, it says that it produces alkaline water ranging on a pH scale of 4 to 10, but this confused me for a second. This is because alkaline means basic, and that means that the water has a pH above 7. Below that's acidic, so I wasn't really sure how you produce basic water with a pH of 4. I kind of just assumed they were using the term alkaline water as a generic term for ionized water, but I really don't know. Just a couple lines below it, it says that it has 5 solid platinum titanium double-sized mesh slotted plates. To me, this sounded really fancy, and it really helped justify the $1,500 cost. Okay though, in all seriousness, this is just a random ionizer that I found in 2 seconds of Googling, but there are cheaper ones. The general range of these water ionizers is between $100 and $2,000, and I'm assuming this depends on the features or quote-unquote quality that you're getting out of it. The more expensive ionizers will often have a bunch of extra features, whether they're useful or not is up to debate, and they'll also use fancy terminology to try to justify the extra cost. So this is the most expensive method to make alkaline water, but there are cheaper alternatives for the frugal people out there who want to be cured of everything, but, you know, can't afford this machine. In very simple terms, the cheap method is just adding some basic stuff to water.
Alright, so today we're going to make a little alkalizing water. All you have to do in order to do that is take a little baking soda. And it will have a little bit of a salty taste, but what this does is alkalizes your body. Also, stuff like lemon water, that's actually very good to alkalize your body. And you would not think, sometimes you think of, well, citrus fruits like lemons and oranges, those are acidic, right? Well, just because the fruit itself is acidic doesn't mean that once it enters into your body that it doesn't have an alkalizing effect.
So according to this video, we can just use some baking soda, which is a nice, easy, cheap method, but apparently we can also use lemons? That caught me off guard, and I did a little research and was surprised to see how many people claim lemons are alkalizing. This guy says, and I quote, "Just because the fruit itself is acidic doesn't mean that once it enters your body, it doesn't have an alkalizing effect." It's kind of funny because that's literally exactly what it means. Out of all the websites I found, nobody actually explains how it's alkalizing, so I've gone ahead and come up with my own theory. So just quickly, I want to talk about what pH even is. The pH of water is generally determined by the concentration of H+. At a neutral pH of 7, the concentration of OH- and H+ is the same. When it's basic though, the concentration of OH- is higher, and when it's acidic, the concentration of H+ is higher. If an acid is diluted, the concentration of H+ will decrease, and the pH will actually increase. So, for example, if we took a drop of an acid with a pH of 2, and we added to 1 liter of water, it would have a pH that's extremely close to 7, but that's just because we diluted it like crazy. The concentration of the H+ was high in that single drop, but now that it's spread over the entire liter, the concentration is much smaller. So now when we do a calculation to find the pH with this lower concentration, the pH we get is more basic. Out of all the websites I found, nobody actually explains how it's alkalizing, but I'm assuming this is what they're claiming. After you ingest the lemon, it just gets more diluted, and therefore the pH increases. This really has nothing to do with an alkalizing effect, it's just how basic concentrations and the pH system works. That's kind of a tangent, but what I'm pretty much just trying to say is that there are some cheap ways to make alkaline water that doesn't cost $1,000. In the end, it's pretty much all pointless and a waste of time, but you know, at least it can be a cheap waste of time. So now that we know some methods to make alkaline water, we should talk now about what it is and how it's supposed to make us feel good. As I said before, alkaline water is just slightly basic water, and so it has a concentration of OH- that's slightly higher than the concentration of H+. So that seems pretty simple, but I mean, you know, how does that help you health-wise? I can't get into the details of everything, but I'm gonna try to address the most common claims that are made. By far the most common claim is that it balances your body pH, but there's a lot of other claims like it helps or cures cancer, detoxes the body, prevents diabetes, and just for fun I added that it protects from nuclear fallout. In general, supporters claim that certain foods are bad and promote quote-unquote acidic conditions. It's believed that disease thrives in acidic conditions, so your body has to work extra hard to get rid of these acidic conditions and restore alkalinity. This whole process stresses the body, and on top of having acidic conditions, this stress can also lead to disease. Alkaline water and an alkaline diet apparently helps neutralize the acidic conditions and solve all the problems related to an acidic environment. Blood and most bodily fluids have a pH between 7.35 and 7.45, and maintaining it within this range is critical. The pH of the blood is extremely tightly regulated by the kidney and the lungs. The kidneys help by filtering out from the blood acidic or basic things and allowing you to expel it from your body. The lungs help by controlling how much CO2 is in the blood. The more CO2 you have in your blood, the more acidic it will be, so by increasing the rate that you breathe, you can decrease the amount of CO2 and increase your blood pH. A lot of the supporters claim that these organs are stressed by the extra acid, and this is totally unfounded. Controlling the pH is one of their major functions, and doing this doesn't stress them any more than normal. A good comparison would be saying that drinking water is bad because it makes your kidneys work more to filter the water out. Unless someone's drinking, you know, 50 liters of water a day, this is a pretty ridiculous statement, and most people would laugh at it. With that being said, getting a pH imbalance in your body is not very common and it's usually indicative of a greater medical issue. It's definitely not something that you'll get by just eating a bunch of acidic stuff. I've included lists of the major reasons for acidosis and alkalosis in the body, and you can see that there's some pretty clear-cut reasons. You can also see that the reasons are pretty serious, like advanced kidney disease or being poisoned. According to a study I found in 2013 by the British Journal of Nutrition, they say variations in human diets across a plausible range of intakes have been shown to have no effect on blood pH. They go on to say that advocating the consumption of alkalizing foods or supplements and/or removing animal protein from the human diet is not justified by the evidence accumulated over the last several decades. This paper was a review done in 2013, so it aggregated a lot of research done in the last several decades. What this is really saying is that up until now, we don't really have any scientific evidence to prove at all that alkaline water or an alkaline diet does anything for you in terms of altering blood pH. Okay, so apparently an alkaline diet or an acid diet has no effect on your blood pH, but is it possible that even if it doesn't affect your blood pH, that it has an effect on your body? Well, according to recent research, the answer is actually probably yes, it does. Although your blood pH doesn't change if you eat a lot of acidic food, it does mean that your body has to expel more acid. So, in order to expel more acid, the body actually starts shifting around some of its metabolic equilibriums. And some research is finding that the shifting of the equilibriums caused by a high acid diet may actually be detrimental. It's starting to be linked to some serious things like diabetes, systemic hypertension, and cardiovascular problems. So the difference between the claims of the supporters and the facts is subtle, but I think it's pretty important. The consumption of an alkaline diet has an effect on the method that your body uses to balance pH, and it has no direct effect on the actual pH balancing. No matter what you eat, your pH is always going to be balanced, but the method your body chooses can be influenced by what you eat. And like I said before, some recent research is finding that an acidic diet might cause your body to take some methods that aren't exactly great for your health in the long term. So this is the problem with a lot of pseudoscience. The concept of an alkaline diet is somewhat supported by evidence, but then the supporters go on to make all these extra claims that are completely unsubstantiated. All of the unsubstantiated claims revolve around the idea that our diet will control our body pH. As I've already said like 90 times, these claims are completely unsubstantiated and basically viewed as false. Just for fun though, and for the sake of the video, I am going to go over a few of the claims.
In my experience, every cancer can be cured in 2 to 16 weeks. Some cancers can be cured in minutes because every doctor in the world that's in office for 20 years or longer knows cases of spontaneous healing. So that means the second you are alkaline, the cancer already stops. It can take a couple of days, a couple of weeks, but it stops.
So from this video, you can see the kind of claims that they make. They say that cancer thrives in an acidic environment, so if we alkalize our body, we can kill the cancer and make it go away. Before we start, I would like to reiterate what I said before, and that is an alkaline diet has no pH effect on the body, so this claim is basically dead from the start. I honestly did try to find a reasonable argument from supporters as to why cancer needs an acidic environment to survive, but I really didn't find anything. There's a lot of mention that cancer cells produce lactic acid as waste, but I wasn't able to find a single resource which explained why neutralizing the lactic acid would kill the cancer. So I kept digging deeper, and I actually found an interesting paper from the British Journal of Cancer. It specifically addresses the acidity of cancer cells, and it was found that although some types of cancers are a little bit more acidic, in general, most cancers are close to the neutral point or slightly alkaline. So if the cancer cells themselves are neutral, would it not be detrimental to actually be living in an acidic environment? To answer this question, I kept searching, and I found that the area outside of cancer cells does in fact tend to be more acidic than normal. At this point, papers did start to mention lactic acid, and it was thought that cancer cells are just more active and they produce more lactic acid than normal cells. And just like in normal cells, lactic acid is expelled, but in normal cells, blood vessels pick it up and take it away. In tumors though, they don't really have a good blood vessel system, so the waste, like lactic acid, tends to just sit around and build up. The buildup of this lactic acid, mostly due to poor circulation, can lead to an acidic environment. So at this point, I was pretty convinced that lactic acid really doesn't do anything. It's just a waste product that happens to build up, and it's not like it's helping the cancer survive. It doesn't really need it. But then I found something that I really didn't expect. A paper in the Journal of Pathology in 2013 actually concluded that lactic acid, specifically, might actually be really important for cancer cell survival. The lactic acid buildup around the cells makes the environment more acidic, and it induces the formation of new blood vessels, which will bring more oxygen to the cancer cells, and it can also help to inhibit the anti-cancer immune response. Other reports even found that a higher tumor lactate level was correlated to a higher patient death rate. So the ultimate conclusion to this is that there actually might be some truth that cancer thrives in an acidic environment. It's not only just an acidic environment though, and it does specifically need lactic acid. I personally thought this was pretty interesting, and I really didn't expect to find it. Anyway, an alkaline diet or drinking alkaline water would still do absolutely nothing to help this. So in the end, this claim isn't as wrong as I thought. I mean, it's still wrong, it's just not as wrong as I thought it was.
You know, most people don't realize how important detoxification is. I mean, in our environment, we're exposed to up to 500,000 different toxins. So we can't see or taste or smell toxins. So sometimes we don't realize how much are in our environment and how much our body's exposed to them. We also don't realize how important it is to detoxify.
It's so nonspecific that I feel toxins are like the modern day version of evil disease-causing spirits that people used to believe in. To find out how the alkaline water detoxes the body, I did a little research and I found an awesome website. This website claims that the alkaline water flushes acidic waste products from the body and it gently cleanses at a deep cellular level. It really sounded credible, so I just went ahead and believed it. Anyway, just for fun, I scrolled down a bit and I start to read some testimonials. Pat A says it helped my eyes right away, it dissolved the cataracts. Yeah, that totally happened. My favorite one though was from Sandra B from Oak Park, Illinois. She says, just got results of blood tests from my doctor, he said no trace of diabetes in your blood. At this point, I honestly laughed because they weren't even trying to make a credible testimonial. Diabetes isn't a thing that floats around in your blood, it's a disorder. You can't just put blood under the microscope and look at the diabetes. Anyway, I thought this site was kind of funny, but this actually leads me to my next point, the treatment of diabetes using alkaline water.
Well, what we've found, in fact, we've seen complete reversals with this program, even in type 1 diabetes. In the two control studies we've done, 83% who were type 1 diabetics were able to either eliminate their insulin injections completely, or in 96% of those who are type 2 diabetics were able to eliminate all of their medications on this program.
So this clip is a little bit old, but it still represents the same belief system that some people have today. In the video, he mentions type 1 diabetes being cured by alkaline water. But type 1 either means that your pancreas produces very little or no more insulin. Most or all of the cells that produce insulin are basically destroyed. It's not known exactly how this happens, but it's known that it's not related to diet. It's believed that it's most likely the result of the immune system attacking itself and killing the cells. Type 2 diabetes is very different because the insulin-producing cells are still intact, just the cells in your body have become more resistant to insulin, so they don't absorb glucose properly. He's making a pretty bold claim that with an alkaline diet or drinking alkaline water, people with type 1 can stop needing to inject insulin. This statement is totally unfounded and it honestly makes me angry a little bit. The entire issue is that the body doesn't produce enough insulin on its own due to a lack of functioning cells. These cells are dead and gone and no diet of any sort will ever bring them back. So unless your alkaline diet involves somehow slipping in insulin into your food, you're still not going to be producing any insulin. These kinds of statements and pseudoscience actually bother me because it encourages people with type 1 diabetes to stop taking their insulin, which can be potentially life-threatening. On the other hand, type 2 diabetes can be controlled by your diet. As I said before, some research has been coming out that insulin resistance might actually be linked to an acidic diet. So it actually makes sense because people with type 2 diabetes are encouraged to eat more fruits and vegetables, which are actually more alkaline foods. So again with another part of the pseudoscience where there is some legit evidence to support their claims, but they go on to make up stuff and to say things that are completely unfounded. I explained earlier that an alkaline diet might actually be linked to diabetes by altering the way the kidneys control the blood pH. A lot of the supporters still hold on to the idea though that it changes the body pH, which, like I said before, is totally false. Then some go even as far as to claim that it can cure type 1 diabetes, which is a pretty bold statement. So basically, in conclusion, the concept of an alkaline diet isn't complete garbage. There is some scientific data and evidence to support the idea that an alkaline diet might be more beneficial than a high acid diet. Unfortunately though, the actual information and fact get skewed and shrouded with misinformation. Then suddenly, before we know it, it's suddenly being pushed as a cure for cancer and AIDS. It's at this point, and where we're at with a lot of the pseudosciences, where it becomes not so funny anymore, because people will actually choose an alkaline diet over chemotherapy, and as a result, they die. So that got a little bit serious there, but to lighten things up, I'll leave you guys with our resident expert who has some awesome information to share.
And the reason being is because alkaline water decreases the cluster size of the water molecule, and is able to penetrate and distill out this red raspberry actual herb.